guys, it's Jackie McRae and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, please remember to click that subscribe button and give this video a big thumbs up. So it has been 7 months since I got engaged. We are going to be getting married next year in October, but I am so excited for this wedding. I've been planning like crazy. I've been doing a bunch of stuff and I know it's a little bit early to do my DIY proposal boxes, but I've honestly just been so excited. I could not wait. So I went out and I got this box, which I will show you the contents of and I will explain everything that I put in there. I tried to do this at the lowest cost as possible while still keeping the quality very nice. Let's get on to the video. For my bridesmaid's proposal box, it's this really cute pink and white striped box. I actually got this from a store around my house. They were going out of business, so everything was on clearance. Each of these boxes was $3.99, but you can always find cheap alternatives on Amazon or Etsy. I was looking there too, but honestly, with the shipping and tax, I just figured I might as well buy it from this store because it was on clearance. If you guys can get this stuff around your house, I would suggest doing that because honestly, Amazon shipping can be a lot. So starting off, when the girls open their boxes, I use these stick-on pearls. They just have a little adhesive underneath, but it basically will just have the initial of the girl's name. This is going to one of my maid of honors, Rebecca. That is why there is a pearl-shaped R here. The pearls I got from Michael's, I think it was only $2, but this was left over from the hair accessories video, which I will put somewhere on the screen if you guys would like to check that out as well. I just had these left over, so it saved me a lot of money. Then for the interior, I'm just gonna give you guys a little view of what the inside looks like, and I'm going to explain everything that is in my box. Starting off, I have this little paper package. It says, "Will you be my maid of honor?" These paper bags actually came blank, but what I did was I went onto Google Images and I searched up a "Will you be my maid of honor" sign, and I just drew it in cursive onto the paper bag. Basically, all I did was I traced all the letters just to make it look a bit nicer and to make it look more put together. I screwed this up a little bit though because I am left-handed and the ink was still a little wet, so I got a little bit of it on the package, but I tried to do my best to fix it and make sure that my hand didn't touch the ink. But basically what I have in here are little beauty products that don't really match the color scheme of my box, so I'm basically kind of just tucking them away. My box is very beauty based, so this will help you cut costs as well. I went to the extreme a little bit because I got too excited when I went to Shoppers, so I got a mask and then I had some coming from Amazon. It was crazy, but you can cut costs by not putting as much stuff in here as I did as far as like the masks and that kind of stuff goes. If you want your box to be a bit cheaper, just don't get as many face masks as I did. When you go into the little bag, I've given each girl two of these mini Neutrogena face wipes. So these are just for removing makeup. I thought they were so adorable. Anything in mini size is just the cutest thing, and to be honest, everybody loves mini size things. It's just adorable. These basically came in a bag of I think 24 or something like that. I think I bought these for $15 Canadian. Obviously, I came to Florida and Brian and I have done a little bit of home decor. So we ended up going to Bed Bath & Beyond. The same exact bag that I bought for $15 was there for $5.99. So I basically paid $10 more for the exact same product. I could have just waited, but I figured I might as well mention where you can get them cheaper because I kind of messed that up and paid $10 more when I didn't need to. I'm also going to do a little goodie bag for them on the bachelorette trip. I'm hoping to do a trip for my bachelorette. Honestly, with this whole COVID, I'm not really sure. I want to make sure everybody's safe, but because there are so many in this little bag, I kind of wanted to put two in the bridesmaids proposal boxes and then two in the bachelorette like goodie bags. And next up, these I got off of Amazon. They are gold collagen eye masks. They're actually really good. These came in a package of 30, which is why I'm putting two in each proposal box. blocks, and then I'm also gonna do that for their goodie bag as well. Because there were so many left over, I actually had a chance to try these out and they're really, really good. I'm kind of happy that I'm giving these to my girls because it's nice to kind of pamper yourself during such stressful times. And I'm all for that self-love beauty night. Because it is gold and blue, I kind of wanted those hidden, so that is why they are in this paper bag. Then each girl is also getting a little Nivea lip balm. I think it came in a package of four, which is why I picked it up, but I got these from Rexall, but you guys can just get them from any sort of drugstore, pharmacy, beauty store. They're super easy to find and they're not that expensive. The next thing I also got from Rexall, this is just a Tiffany blue colored nail polish. I know the bride is supposed to be the one that gets something blue, but I kind of wanted to put that in my bridesmaids proposal boxes as well. I thought that'd be super cute. They were actually having a sale on these nail polishes. I think it was $3 for $8, which is why I picked them up. And then for the fourth, I just got two other nail polishes for myself. I absolutely love this. This is from Sinful Colors. It's in the shade Wonder Mint, but it looks like the Tiffany blue color. This I also got off of Amazon. It is a rose water sheet face mask. I got these in a package of 10. So I'll probably put one in the bridesmaids proposal box and one in the bachelorette goodie bag. I really wanted to get something rose scented. I think roses are so nice and they smell amazing. And who doesn't love to be pampered in a bunch of roses? I loved how the packaging has all these pretty flowers on it. It looks so amazing. It goes so well in the box, and there's two left over, which means I potentially get to use it as well. And then finally in the beauty section, I also got these. I got these from Rexall. I think they were $2 each. At the time that I got these, I was so excited. I really wanted to get my bridesmaids proposal boxes kind of together. I wasn't sure if I was gonna order those face masks off of Amazon because the shipping was insane. So I just went out and got this one from Rexall. I was just super excited, so that's why I got that. And I ended up switching my address to Brian's address on Amazon, and my shipping was like $100 cheaper, so I kind of just went with that. Like, thank God my fiance lives here because it made my shipping expenses a lot cheaper. I put a lot of beauty products in my bridesmaids proposal boxes, but if you guys want something a bit cheaper, you can just cut out some of those. Next up, I got this Henkel Rosé. It's just a mini bottle of rosé. It's sparkling. It's really, really good. It comes in a package of 3. This I got from the LCBO. So I had to buy 2 of these packages, and I had 2 rosés left over, so I tried it because, to be honest, like, I'm trying everything in these boxes. But also, if you're gonna give a gift, you might as well make sure that it's a good gift to give. I don't know, is that like good reasoning to be trying some of your bridesmaids? But anyway, I did drink it. It was really good. So I feel totally fine giving this to my bridesmaids. It actually does taste really good. I've seen a lot of girls take little label makers and just write, "Will you be my bridesmaids?" on these. I was debating doing that, but I found them on Amazon, and I think the cheapest I could find them for was $7. And the measurements just weren't fitting the bottle right. So I just decided to write, "Will you be my bridesmaid or maid of honor?" on the paper bags instead, and just leave the normal sign on the rosé. But obviously, to each is your own. If you want to put it on the rosé or wine bottle, if you're gonna have it, you can find them really cheap on Amazon. And the last thing in my bridesmaid's proposal box is this beautiful silk robe. It just says bridesmaid on the back. I got a bunch of these for my bridesmaids, and they're actually really great quality. I think these were $13.99, but it just says bridesmaid on the back of it in little sequins. And I was actually surprised with the quality. This is actually really good for the amount of money that I paid. And the sequins look amazing too. Each one of my bridesmaids is going to be getting one of these robes as well. Basically for the robe, all I did was I measured the side of the box because I did want some of the bridesmaids sign to show. And I folded this up myself after I got it from the package, and I made sure that it was super cute and folded well into the box. And then I just put the little tie that comes with it folded in between, and then I just placed it nicely in the box. I also wanted to mention this. This isn't a part of the gift, but all this little crinkle paper. When I went looking on Amazon, one bag of these was, I think, $6.99, and I ended up finding them at Party City for $1.99 or $2.99 a bag, so I saved a bunch of money. So I figured I would just mention that to you guys as well. If you are looking for a cheaper alternative, go to Party City and you will get this crinkled. Great. Go to Party City and you will be able to get this crinkled paper for much cheaper. It was so much fun making these bridesmaids proposal boxes. I had so much fun going around and collecting all of these items. I'm so happy with the way these boxes turned out. I know my bridesmaids are going to absolutely love these, so I can't wait to give it to them. I'm not really sure when this is gonna be. I might have to upload this before I give it to them just because it's going to take so long to actually get around to giving all of my bridesmaids their boxes. I'm not really sure how I'm gonna do it, but if you guys subscribe to my channel, you will kind of see because I'll probably post this one and then my bridesmaids' reactions. Anyway, that is everything. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. Please remember to comment, like, and subscribe to my channel. I will be posting new videos every week. And I also have a wedding series on my channel where I try on wedding dresses, do stuff like DIY proposal boxes. I'll also be posting my bachelorette and stuff like that. So if you guys want to follow along my wedding series, make sure to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned with that. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you in my next one. Bye!